Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. I decided to do a sort of different but an interesting video today. So now I know that your laptop might seem as boring or something and you might want it to look nice, you know. So I've seen a lot of MacBook customization updates and all that, but I've never seen an Android one, and that makes me feel as though like there can be no customization done, whereas in fact the truth is a lot can be done. So today I'm going to take you guys with me so that I can show you guys some ways you can make your laptop look nice and good, and hopefully that will help you. And if you find any of that helpful, make sure to subscribe and hit the like button, as that will help me a lot.
The most famous reindeer of all, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, had a very shiny nose.
Okay, so I was writing it down right now, and I've got a couple of them which I will be showing you guys and explaining you guys, and they might not be in order. I will put the exact order in the comment section so that you guys can just click on the number and know what to do. So the first one is how to change icons into a sort of graphic or a cute thing like this one. The second one is a wallpaper setup. It's a very basic thing, but I'm still going to make it for you guys and show it so that those who don't know can get an idea. The third one is a Chrome change in Chrome background. The fourth one is a very simple one again, and that is adding a to-do list. And the last one is how to make a screensaver. Stay tuned for that one. So what I do over here, okay. So what I do over here is, first you can just take any picture that you want. Okay, so first you go to her website, which is okay, let me just like take you to the juliakchrist.com. And once you go over there, that website has a bunch of like things. You can get her merch if you want or anything. Click on the looking for free graphics one. Oops, there's an ad. Okay, and over there you have a bunch of things you can do. My camera. Okay, over there you have a bunch of things you can do, and so over there you go and click on desktop icons. Once that is done, you see you have a bunch of icons over there. I'm just going to select the iced coffee circle, which is the very recent one she added. Now you just click on that image and then you save it into like whatever you want. Now just a reminder that once you download it, you cannot like just put this image into an icon because it is not in that format. At least for Android it didn't work for me. So what you have to do over here is convert the file to ICO format, that is the icon format. So you just type convert to ICO and you get the website. This is my website that I use, not mine, but something I use. So once you do that, you just upload the picture you downloaded over there and you click on the picture, download it. It takes time to upload. I mean, by then, if you have not yet subscribed, make sure to subscribe, because I would love to reach 500 before January. That would be super cool. Help me out. Okay, there we go. It's done. Now you just download the file. There we have the ICO format. Now you minimize this and you go to like this thing. Okay, I'm just going to change the icon over here. You go to properties and then you click on customize, and then you click on this change icon thing. I have already changed, which is why there's a different icon. You click on browse, and on downloads you have this. Just a reminder, only if it is in the ICO format will the image pop up, otherwise it won't. So yeah, once you click on that, click on OK, and then make sure to click on apply. Don't be dumb like I was, otherwise it won't work out. And then you click on OK, and there you go. Simple as that. So the next one I'm going to show you guys is how to just apply a background to your desktop and make it look nice. Now this is the most basic thing, so we'll go through it fastly, but I'll also tell you where to get some good wallpapers. So I'm again going to go to Julia's website, and over there she has a section called MacBook Screensavers. Now it's not necessarily for MacBook, works for anything, you know, Android or anything, and she has a bunch. I look ugly. She has a bunch of absolutely, I'm sorry. She has a bunch of amazing ones that I love. Like, I literally use only her wallpapers because they're just amazing. So what you do is you just like click on one. It takes you to another site, right click, save, download, and you're good to go. Now, the one I showed you guys was something that's fine, but if you're like choosing like this one, what happens is it doesn't exactly fit in my desktop, like it desktop, at least it didn't fit for me. So what I did is I went to Canva. Over there I just typed, I just typed laptop screensaver, I don't know what you call it, desktop wallpaper, exactly, I'm not spelling it right, my camera is, and then I just click on create a blank desktop wallpaper, that's loading, okay, and I had already uploaded it yesterday over here, so I have it, otherwise you just click on upload media, device, and upload the picture, whatever picture that is, and then you just like drag it and hold it over here, so it just automatically fits the entire screen and you do not need to extend it. And once that is done, download, and after that the picture is downloaded, you then go to like your desktop background, click on personalize. Now it need not necessarily be personalized for everyone. Some of them, like Windows 8, have properties, that is the one I'm talking about. You click on browse. You click on browse and you click on that picture that you want, and that's it. There you go, a beautiful nice look to your laptop. Next one I'm going to talk about is an simpler one, but I had no clue you could do that till recent, but it's okay, we all learn as we grow. So here's what we are going to do. Let me just start screen recording. Another reminder. Okay, let's go for it. This is a pretty cool app too. Okay, so what you're going to do is go to, okay, you open a whole new tab on your Google, you can see on the screen. So this had not come with my laptop or anything, I had to set it up. So this is also downloaded from Julia's website, and this is from the MacBook screen savers section. So you can see this is the one I choose. Now you have a small edit pen option that I didn't notice until recently. I don't even know what to say about that, but it's fine, I guess. Let me know in the comments if you guys didn't notice it too. So you just click on that like pen edit thing, and you can either choose from Google or you can click upload from device, and then you can just choose the picture. Now I cleaned out my computer yesterday, so I don't see that picture over here, but that's all you have to do. That's, you click the picture, upload it, and you're good to go. I guess I'll just download it again for you guys so that it's much easier for you. You click on the downloaded image, and there you have, Google has set it up for me. Hey, so I actually lost footage of this one, so I'm just going to do like a voiceover over here. So first of all, you search sticky notes in the bar. I already have it, so all I'm going to do is just like click the plus button and extend it. Now once that is done, I'm going to just drag it over to a clean place, and you have to click on that image icon that you can see. In Android, you don't get to do the copy paste thing. Now this is the drawing that I made, so I'm just going to like copy paste it over here. I'm going to drag it until like I get the image I want accordingly, and it's just like a cute touch. Now I'm going to teach and explain to you guys the most important and fun part, which I'm extremely excited about because it has just given me the best look to my laptop, and that is how to do a screensaver thing. Now I do not know how to show you guys that. I'll try my best to take a clean picture, but it gives you a timing. So when your laptop has been inactive for pretty long, it gives you this timing so you don't have just a normal black screen, but you have a good look that gives your laptop, even when it's inactive, you can still see the time and be aware when you have classes like now, online classes, you know, so yeah. Okay, so I spoke, but I realized I didn't start the recording, so yay. So let me start the recording and I'll start explaining you guys how it's done. So first you have to go to the site, that's flicklo.com. I will mention it in the description so it's easier for you guys. And as you keep scrolling down, you have this option called version 1.3.3 for Windows. Again, it's free, so download it. I have already downloaded it, so I'm not going to do that again. Once you download it, you will get in a WinZip sort of file. Just extract it. For Windows, you don't need to pay, at least I don't have to. You just need to like click on right click, extract here, and you're good to go. Now once you click on that file, this is how it opens. Yeah, I don't know what's happening, wait. I'm so sorry. So once you do that, you click on the folder, and over here you have the setup. So as you double click on it, it's going to like come like this. Do you want to allow this app to make changes? Now obviously it's going to ask that, because it is going to be as a screensaver, and obviously that is a change to a laptop. So you can go on with yes. And once that is done, they show you this thing over here. Shouldn't take much time, at least for me it didn't. Now see, this is how it is shown. I'll click on preview, and this is how it comes. So when your laptop is inactive or anything, this is what is going to be shown on your laptop. Perfectly nice and a beautiful touch again to your laptop. Were five of the tips that I used to make my laptop look more nice and neat and organized. Again, the rest depends on how you set your folder. A pro tip is that you set your folders according to how the wallpaper is. So I'm not keeping my folders on the words, I'm keeping on the empty spaces, so in that way it looks nice and neat. So that is a pro tip for you. So you guys got 6 tips, 6 ideas you can use to make your laptop look nice. If this helped you in any way, make sure to subscribe, because that will help me loads and in helping me reach my 500 goal. Stay tuned for another videos, and I love you all. Have a nice day.